once upon a time, when the world was not so very much younger than it is now, there was a boy named Kyriakos. Kyriakos lived in a little village in Greece with his mother and his old grandfather. They and their neighbors worked hard all day in the fields, but none so hard as those who had no animals to help them. Kyriakos liked pets. He was on the best of terms with half the barnyard animals in the village. He had a goat of his own named Aspasia and a dog named Hero. He knew the way to make friends with anything on four legs. The neighbors used to say he could talk to animals in their own language, but of course we all know better than that. Now there was one thing Kyriakos wanted more than anything else in the world, and that was a donkey. He had even decided on its name, Kula. Some of the neighbors had donkeys, but his family had lost all their livestock in the war, the same war his father had been killed in. Kyriakos had hopes of getting one, or at least a mule, because he knew the Marshall Plan was sending lots of them from America to Greece. Months before, a committee had met in the village, and Kyriakos' grandfather had gone down along with a lot of others. Each one in turn was given a chance to explain to the committee how much he needed an animal to help with his work. Those whose need was judged greatest were to have their names put on a list, and in time they would get their animals. Kyriakos' grandfather was picked, among others, and his name was written down, but then nothing had happened. Grandfather had had a feeling from the very beginning that the whole thing was too good to be true, so after a while he had just dismissed it from his mind. But not Kyriakos. Grandfather's name, all written out in plain sight. He and three other men from the village were to have mules all the way from America. Miles away in Kavala, the nearest port, a ship was docked at that very moment. Though Kyriakos, of course, didn't know it. The ship had already begun to discharge its cargo. Hundreds of mules from Missouri and Arkansas, from Texas and Oklahoma and Mississippi. Aboard ship, the captain and some American officials were going through the formalities of turning over the cargo to the Greek government. Once unloaded, the mules were shipped off in big trucks to different places for distribution. Those for Kyriakos' village, along with many others, set out for Xanthi, where the men of the village were to go and claim them on the day appointed. By dawn of the great day, Kyriakos' mother and sister were up and about, getting the men ready for their journey. for Xanthi was many miles away. Kyriakos could hardly contain himself because grandfather had consented to let him go along. To be a great adventure. The men would not be back for at least 2 days, and hardly anyone in the family had ever been that far away from home before. The journey was long and slow, and night overtook them on the way. Next day, the sun was already high in the sky. In the big enclosure where the mules were tied up, grandfather left Kyriakos to go see about the papers to be filled out. Kyriakos had been told to stay right there, but one look at the mules, so different from anything he'd ever seen, and Kyriakos forgot his instructions completely. The more he looked at those strange big animals, the more he liked them. And there stood one in particular. He knew it at a glance. Its name could only be Kula. Imagine how Kyriakos felt when he found out. Everything was not perfect for Kyriakos, though. Grandfather insisted on taking charge of Kula himself on the grounds that so dangerous an animal should not be entrusted to a boy. Though the mules had been broken in before they left America, they were still upset. So were the farmers. There was one in the village, though, who was not. Spring weather seemed to have gotten into Kula's blood. He was listless and uninterested. He refused to walk a straight line or concentrate on his work. Thank you. once, Kyriakos' way with animals seemed to have failed him. He was at his wit's end. Then suddenly he had an idea. An idea not soon to be forgotten in the village. Kyriakos had decided that Kula was just lonesome. What he wanted was some company, a more experienced friend to help show him what to do. For a while, it was a delicate situation. Kula liked it very much, but his little teammate was not quite so sure. Things were still not going quite right, but by now Kyriakos knew that he had regained his touch. So the plowing went well after all, and up and down the countryside, as farmers learned to handle their new American mules, their lives became just a little easier. Their farms became just a little more productive, and Greece itself became just a little happier land to live in.